Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. A couple of weeks ago on this channel, I looked at a paper that studied how novice programmers, students mostly, used Copilot and the patterns of behavior that emerged from that kind of usage. And an interesting similar question to ask after that would be, well, that's for novice programmers. What about more experienced or professional programmers? How do they use Copilot and what behavior patterns do we see when they do that? And this is the paper that does that. To give you a very quick TLDR, the authors did discover two major modes of usage. One was acceleration mode, where the programmers just use it to get what they want faster. And the other is exploration mode, where they, as the name suggests, use Copilot to explore options. If you go check out that other paper, you'll see that these are very analogous to the shepherding and drifting patterns that the authors of that previous paper discovered when looking at novice programmers. But there's a lot more interesting detail in here, so let's dive in. This study used 20 participants, and this table shows their level of experience. You can see a lot of them are professionals, some are occasional programmers, some are students, but postdoc or PhD students who would have had more experience programming. This column called PCU stands for prior Copilot usage, and you'll see that roughly half of them had some prior experience using Copilot and the other half didn't. This crowd of 20 programmers were given three different tasks. Some of them were given the task of coding up a chat client and server. Others were given a problem from the advent of code. And the third problem was to write code to detect Benford's law. By the way, Benford's law says that you're more likely to find smaller digits as the first digit of a numerical data set. And so the problem was to do some statistical analysis on a data set to see if it indeed does follow Benford's law. The authors found two big classes of behavior when using Copilot. The first one is acceleration mode, and the second one is exploration mode. In acceleration mode, as the name implies, the programmer is always in their state of flow. They know the end result of the code that they would have wanted, but they're just using Copilot to get it done faster. In exploration mode, on the other hand, there is some important part of the problem that the programmer is unsure about. It could be the syntax, it could be an API, or which algorithm to use. And they are then using Copilot to help them explore the design space of the solution. And of course, these modes are not exclusive. Programmers will often switch between these two modes as they are solving a problem. In acceleration mode, the programmer is very much in charge of what's happening. This is the mode in which Copilot is basically super intelligent autocomplete. Programmers tend to be in acceleration mode when they have already understood and decomposed the task into smaller pieces. And when they are in acceleration mode, they want small targeted suggestions just for the piece of code that they're immediately looking to complete and no more than that. This is where Copilot's tendency to sometimes suggest very long completions can break the sense of flow. The authors found that the programmers would quickly validate the suggestions. As we saw, they use acceleration mode when they already know what the code would have looked like. So they're looking for a specific structure to the code, some keywords, a particular API call, and if they see that, they're reasonably confident that Copilot got it right. Acceleration mode also means that if something doesn't look right about the suggestion, programmers don't want to repair it. They'd rather just reject the suggestion and keep going on themselves. Now, looking at exploration mode, the roles are very much flipped, with Copilot now being in the driver's seat. Programmers tend to use exploration mode when they're faced with a new task that they're somewhat unfamiliar with. Not surprisingly, the authors found that the participants who trusted Copilot more or were more excited about it tended to use exploration mode more. They were excited when they saw fully functional code come out of a top-level comment. It was like the model writing the code for you, as one participant said. And this is where you most see the comment-driven style of programming that Copilot has now made popular. People will explicitly write comments that nudge Copilot towards a solution, or write very long and detailed comments, or try out different kinds of comments when they're in exploration mode. And then I found this somewhat ironic, all those detailed comments that programmers would put in when trying to nudge Copilot, they would then remove after Copilot gave them a suggestion that they liked. In other words, they were thinking of these comments as something for the model rather than something that would help future human programmers as they were reading this code. Of course, exploration mode is also the place where programmers look at not just one of Copilot's inline suggestions, but the multiple suggestions in the side pane that Copilot provides. Another interesting behavior was that when Copilot makes multiple suggestions, programmers would often cherry pick code out of multiple suggestions and then combine it into their final solution. Now, there's an interesting pattern of behavior in how programmers would validate suggestions when in exploration mode. Contrast this with when in acceleration mode, the programmer had a good idea of the code that they wanted and they would just quickly eyeball it to validate it. But when they're in exploration mode, they're not quite sure what they're looking for, so they're not sure if the suggestion is good. And this is where they rely on somewhat heavier validation techniques, like actually executing the code. For example, if you're in Python, you can execute that code in a REPL, or running some kind of static analysis or a type checker, say if you're programming in Rust, or even looking up the documentation to see if the API calls in the suggestion make sense for the problem being solved. So how much time do programmers spend in each mode? This is a graphic that shows time on the x-axis and each of the 20 programmers on the y-axis. The bluish colors are acceleration mode activities. The reddish colors are exploration mode activities. And as you can see, most of their time is spent in exploration mode with quick interspersed bursts of acceleration mode, which is what you'd expect because they're just going very fast. They know what they want when they're in acceleration mode. And when they're in exploration mode, they're going much slower and they're looking around. Now, there's one important disadvantage of using Copilot for exploration, and that is that generated code is harder to debug because you don't have a good understanding of what the code should have been doing because you're exploring. If there's a bug or an error in that code, it is much harder to debug. The authors wrap up with some recommendations about how Copilot or other AI assistants could better help programmers in the future. The first one is having more awareness of what exactly you're prompting Copilot with. Is it looking at the entire file? Is it looking at multiple files? Just the current method? All that is quite opaque, and so programmers can't build a good mental model of what exactly Copilot is using to produce its suggestions. Another somewhat directly obvious suggestion from this study is that Copilot should be aware of whether the programmer is in exploration mode or acceleration mode, and then tailor its completion experience for that mode. For example, we saw that when the programmer is in acceleration mode and Copilot throws up a very long suggestion, that breaks their sense of flow. I think this next one is a really promising idea, which is to produce suggestions that have an overall structure with holes or blanks in that structure. And then those holes can be filled in either by the programmer by hand or by then giving more targeted prompts for those specific pieces of code. All right, so that was a quick look at a paper that studied how experienced programmers use Copilot. If you like content like this, please like the video, consider subscribing to the channel, leave questions or comments down below. Thank you very much, and I will see you next time.